So I claimed in the last video that we made a $5 risk-free profit by spending $38 to buy a call and a bond, and we got $43 by shorting a stock and essentially writing a put option. What I want to do in this video is verify that we really do have all of our bases covered. So let's just think about all of the different scenarios for the underlying stock price at option expiration, because that's the date that we care about. So let's take the situation where the stock just becomes, where the stock just goes to zero. So in that situation, the call that we own is worthless. The call is worthless. No reason why you'd want to exercise the option to buy it for $35 when the stock is worth zero. But the good thing is that when we now have to cover our short, remember, when you short something, you're borrowing the stock and selling it, and in the future you have to buy the stock to cover your short, to buy the stock and return it to whomever you borrowed it from. So now we can spend $0. We can now spend $0 to buy stock and essentially give it back to whom we borrowed it from, or essentially cover the short, to buy stock to cover or unwind short, to cover the short. The bad thing is that put option that we wrote, remember, we wrote it, we sold the put option. We're giving someone else the right to sell the stock to us for $35. And if the stock price is worth zero, they're going to exercise that option. Because they can buy the stock for zero and they can sell it to us for $35. So we have to spend $35 to buy the stock from put holder. But the good thing is that we have this bond. We own this bond that's now worth $35. We have a $35 bond. We have a $35 bond. So we can use the $35 bond to spend the $35, essentially give that $35 to the holder of the put, and everything cancels out. So we can still keep our original $5. So that's the situation where the stock price went to zero. What about the situation where the stock price goes to something crazy? Let's say the stock price goes to 70. So the stock price goes up. Let me draw a little column over here. So now let's think about the scenario where the stock price goes to 70. Now all of a sudden, the call option we have, remember, it's an option to buy the stock at $35. The call is worth $35. The call is worth $35. We have a bond that's going to be worth $35. A bond worth $35. The put option is worthless, so the person who we wrote the put for, they won't exercise it. So the put is worthless. The put is worthless. But we still have to cover our short. We have to buy back the stock and return the stock to whomever we borrowed it from. And now, to cover our short, to buy the stock, it's going to cost us $70. So we're going to have to use this $70, the $35 from the call and $35 from the bond, to actually cover our short position. So $70 to buy stock and cover short. And what you'll see is, I just picked kind of a low stock price and a high stock price. But no matter what the stock price is, you're going to be able to cover all of your obligations and break even at expiration and keep your original risk-free $5. Now, the reality of the situation is that opportunities like this seldom exist because, frankly, people can write computer programs to find these arbitrage opportunities and just exploit them really, really, really fast.